The late Joanna Mazikagezi was assassinated on March 30, 2015 in Chiwatule, a Kampala suburb. At the time of the attack, Kagezi was lead prosecutor in the 2010 Kampala bombings. It is over 8 years since Kagezi's death. The killers are yet to be caught. President Yoweri Museveni, who spoke at the 6th memorial lecture of the late Joan Kagezi in Munyonyo today, said the killers are known and belong to the rebel group Allied Democratic Forces. The UPDF is currently pursuing the ADF in the Democratic Republic of Congo. President Museveni wondered, after all these years, the police have failed to arraign the killers in the courts of law. He blamed it on laxity on the part of the DPP and the investigative arm of the police. The president further asked the police CID director, Tom Magambo, to find these killers immediately so they can face the law.
The shooters. First of all, in the case of John Kagezi, it is really the laxity of the police, I think, of the CID. This is because immediately we had a rough idea of the killer. Immediately. I was therefore surprised when later on I heard that they had not, but the new CID director, I think, knows the information we had. And there may be some other complications, especially when the killers are living abroad. But I think that does not stop us from exposing them.
Members of the justice, law and order sector raised a number of concerns impeding their smooth operations. Among them was the understaffed office of the Director of Public Prosecution and lack of a witness protection law.
We sincerely thank you for giving support to the judiciary. That has enabled them to recruit some more staff. However, there are still many places without magistrates and judges, meaning Your Excellency, the Chief Justice still needs your support in order to fulfill his dream of reaching every sub-county.
They say there was an urgent need for a legal framework on the protection of witnesses, prosecutors, and all legal officers.
Need for a witness protection law, resources for security, and the need for more numbers. I am aware of the many competing demands against the limited national resource envelope. If you asked me to stick to only one request today, that you cause Section 21 of the Income Tax Act to be amended to add your prosecutors among the criminal justice actors on those exempted from income tax.
One of the areas where we fail the criminal justice system is cases do not take off immediately. And as I said, witnesses disappear, some die, some move on, some lose interest in the case. They think the courts of law are not serious. Fortunately, it is not the Director of Public Prosecutions who is blamed. It is the Chief Justice and his courts which is blamed for matters over which we have no control.
Meanwhile, different people reflected on the life of the late Joan Kagezi, including her former colleagues and children.
To come to these events, I can imagine that this is not an easy day out. She was a true champion of justice and an inspiration to us all. and I cannot overemphasize how much this event last year has played on my mind ever since. So let us honor her legacy by continuing the fight against organized crime and ensuring that our witnesses are protected and that justice is served. I'd like to express my sincere gratitude to you, Lady Justice Jane Francis, and all of your team and all of those here today for giving me the genuine honor for being able to come and speak with you and for seeing and hearing your commitment for justice for everyone in Uganda.
Such responsibilities in the enactment and application of protection measures are prominently featured in the updated set of principles for the protection and promotion of human rights through action to combat impunity, and the basic principles and guidelines on the right to a remedy and reparation.
Grant us wisdom, O God, to execute our mandate well in a safe environment.
Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.
I ask you, Lord, that you'll bless them in all that they do.